Even though Chumlee is the only Pawn Stars cast member that doesn't belong to the Harrison family, he surely feels like its member, and since every family has that one dummy, that role somehow naturally went to Chumlee. Everyone's favorite village idiot joined the family-run world-famous gold and silver pawn shop long before the show even aired, working behind the counter, loading and testing items, and writing tickets for all purchases, as he and Corey were childhood friends. Today, no one can imagine the show without him, as his goofiness and immatureness, along with his happy-go-lucky attitude, mishaps, and crazy antics made him a fan favorite over the years, so in today's video we'll be checking out 10 times he went full dummy on the show. At some point back in Season 3, a man came to the Gold and Silver Pawn Shop with an unopened and completely sealed box of pre-embargo Cuban cigars from the 40s that he wanted to sell. As fate would have it, the cigars hadn't actually been kept in a humidor, which meant that they probably turned into dust over the years, so the disappointed seller eventually ended up walking home without a deal. While the old man was explaining that the purchase of any Cuban cigars in US soil was not allowed from the 60s onwards, unless they were produced before the embargo, Chumlee was baffled as it didn't make much sense to him, so he asked why they don't just make Cuban cigars in the US. Naturally, without dwelling too much on Chumlee's reasoning, the old man simply replied that it was probably one of the dumbest things he ever said. In one of the Christmas-related episodes, Chumlee struts into the pawn shop full of holiday spirit and wearing a full Santa costume. As Rick and Corey laugh in disbelief, Corey compliments Chum's outfit, but says that the old man beat him to it. The old man, who was sitting at his desk in complete Santa gear like everything is normal, raises his glass and wishes Chumlee a Merry Christmas. However, Chumlee doesn't let that bring him down and later returns wearing a ridiculous Santa's elf costume. The staff bursts out in laughter and the old man says that's probably the worst outfit he's ever seen. As he checks Chumlee's outfit from head to toe, he says, "I look stupid, but that's ridiculous." With that out of the way, the old man goes back to business mode and addresses the business of opening presents. You would think that by the time Season 4 was filmed, the Harrisons would have learned that Chumlee should never, under any circumstances, be left alone and without supervision.
Thank you.
Even though more often than not he seems to be the scapegoat when something goes wrong at the shop, it is mostly well deserved. In one of the episodes from Season 4, he was minding the shop all alone when a man walked into the shop carrying a vintage Gibson mandolin he picked up at a yard sale. He was hoping to make some money off of it so he could take his family on a trip to Ireland. With Rick and Corey out of reach, it was up to Chum to appraise the item. Encouraged by Rick drooling over another mandolin they had in the shop earlier, he decides to go above his purchase limit of $1,000 and seals the deal at $1,500. Even though the mandolin had the decals on the edges and the stamp of the Modern Script Gibson logo was visible through one of the F-holes, it turned out that it was one of the thousands of fakes that can be found across the US. Unfortunately for Chumlee, who was worried about impressing Rick, he lost $1,400, since a friend and music shop owner later estimated the mandolin's worth at just 100 bucks. When a woman brought in an elven marionette from the 1960s, the old man called it Chumlee's first cousin, to which Chumlee happily agreed before singing the title song from Alvin and the Chipmunks cartoon while the old man made a deal for 50 bucks with the customer, and Chumlee started playing with the marionette and even dressed it up later in the episode. After Rick had mistakenly purchased an Indian vest for kids for 1300 bucks that turned out to be unauthentic, Chumlee mocked him by saying that he had found a buyer for the item and showing him the elven marionette wearing the Sioux vest. Though Rick didn't find it very funny, it surely conjured a smile on the viewers' faces. In an episode aptly named Chum's Risky Business from Season 15, a woman entered the pawn shop with boxes and boxes of old comic books she inherited from her uncle. All the comic books she doesn't know anything about were handed down to her and she was looking to sell them, certain there's something valuable in the pile. Judging by the prices on them, Chumlee concluded they date from 70s or 80s, the period also known as the Bronze Age of comics. Without asking for a second opinion, Chumlee started haggling. The woman's initial asking price was $2,000, but Chumlee immediately lowered it, taking into account the time needed to go through all of them and find the diamond in the rough. He offered her $50 per box, which summed up to $350, but they eventually struck a deal at $500, with Chum saying that life is about chances and sometimes you just gotta take him. Unfortunately, when an expert checked the comics out, it turned out that this wasn't the right chance to take, as he said that the comics would sell for about $200 if the Pawn Stars were lucky.
You spent $500
on some comic books I'll be lucky to get like 180 bucks out of, and 7 boxes of the recyclable paper.
Back in the episode titled Little Pawn Shop of Horrors from Season 7, a man came to the shop looking to sell a collection of props from the 1988 horror film Child's Play. The man apparently worked as a production assistant on the movie and wanted to get rid of the props that included a voodoo doll, an amulet, and some knives. Being an amazing entrepreneur that he is, Chumlee decided to buy the props and eventually make his own movie. The result was the movie titled The Pawning, which was practically the same as the reality TV show they're all a part of, except it had a creepy twist. Chumlee's movie featured Rick being killed right before the other guys enjoy a pie made of his remains. While the movie did amuse most of the staff, Rick naturally didn't find it that funny, as he seemed horrified to say the least. Obviously, the fact that the guys made a movie about killing and eating him was more than disturbing.
You guys made a movie about killing me and eating me.
Yeah.
I thought the movie was great.
We all make mistakes, and when we do, admitting them is the way to go, but as it turns out, Chumlee didn't get the memo. In an interview with the Huffington Post, Big Hoss revealed that Chumlee's biggest error in the shop happened before the show even started. After someone pawned their stand-up bass to the shop for $700, Chumlee leaned it against a shelf and walked away, but the bass fell and shattered into pieces. However, instead of telling his bosses about accidentally breaking the instrument, he decided to shove the pieces into a box and put the pawn number on the box as if nothing had happened. When the owner eventually came back to get the bass, he obviously freaked out upon discovering it in pieces, and the pawn shop had to pay the man the full value for it. Since it turned out to be a rare instrument, Rick ended up writing a check for $20,000. In an episode from the first season, a man brought in a 1970s Barnett crossbow, and since he couldn't tell Corey and Chumlee if it still fired, the two decided to take the weapon to the archery range. After telling the expert they didn't know how long the crossbow hadn't been fired, he warned them that it could break and hurt them. Chumlee lost the round of rock, paper, scissors and had to go first, but couldn't even cock the crossbow. However, Corey wasn't much more successful, and even with joint effort, the two got nowhere. The expert, who could hardly conceal his amusement, eventually helped them out and made the two look even more ridiculous by pulling the loading mechanism down fairly easily. Admittedly, Chumlee is not the sharpest knife in the Pawn Stars drawer, which is exactly why Corey decided to play a prank on him in the episode titled One Way Ticket back in Season 8. After seeing that there's a lot of money in the jackpot, Chumlee went on and on about winning the lottery, so Corey decided to screw with him a little bit by bringing him a scratch card. Chumlee immediately decided to scratch it and seemingly won $10,000. He jumped up straight away and tossed his Pawn Stars shirt on the floor, saying that he's going on a vacation. However, Corey then revealed to Rick and the old man that the ticket he bought for Chumlee at the party store was fake, and then he spent the rest of the day trying to reach his buddy to stop him from spending his alleged winnings. Chumlee texted Corey back at some point to let him know that he purchased a ticket to Cayman Islands so he would avoid paying taxes on the money. This made Corey feel rather guilty, so he decided to come clean and confess his prank to Chum, who sounded pretty shocked on the phone. Still, when he came back to the shop later, he said that he hadn't fallen for Corey's prank, but simply used the opportunity to take a day off. Since nobody is comfortable with being a clown all the time, we're not quite convinced. Back in Season 1, in the episode called Pawn Shop in No, the guys from the pawn shop acquired an antique 19th century demijohn with a hand-blown glass, original mechanism, and some actual winemaking history. Naturally, Chumlee immediately decided to put the item to good use and make some foot-crushed wine of his own. After doing a little bit of research into the matter, he happily started to stomp some grapes before filling them in the carboy, adding a rather unusual little bit of red wine for color, along with the required amount of sugar and yeast. He then left it for 3 months to ferment, and eventually offered it to the guys at the shop. Needless to say, they were all kinda skeptical, and the old man went as far as to say that he lived a few decades and through 5 wars, but the thing that might actually get him is drinking Chum's wine. However, after saying an Old Navy toast, he turned out to be the one that sort of liked Chum's unorthodox wine.
Oh, oh. That...
Not that bad.
It's disgusting.
It's not bad, I kinda like it.
Thank you for checking this video out, and don't forget to smash that like button and also subscribe for new videos every day. Turn that bell notification on and comment down below that you subscribed, and we'll make sure to reply and thank as many of you as we possibly can. Once again, thank you for watching, and see you next time.